When you press the button for half a second, the needle moves very little, which indicates that the supplied current is very small. This is a sign that the device is working correctly for the moment. This test gives us an idea of how the device behaves during the power cycle and allows us to continue moving forward to understand it better. On the digital source, we have seen values of 4 or 6 milliamperes. If we keep pressing the power button, the current increases and we have peaks of 600-700 milliamperes. Depending on the range of the device, we can have bigger or smaller peaks. A digital laboratory power supply is a device that measures electrical current as a digital reading instead of an analog reading. This means that it also provides accurate information in numerical format. An analog ammeter, on the other hand, provides an analog reading in the form of a graph or a line. This means that the user must observe it to determine the exact reading, which can take some time. When we are pressing the power button in the first case, after less than a half a second, the current remains fixed at 89 milliamperes. Repeating the process, the same was observed. This indicates a failure, so to solve it is necessary to make measurement on the motherboard, starting with the voltage of the power button and then continuing to measure the inputs and outputs of the PMIC. In the second case, it's noted that the device has suffered a considerable blow. When we're pressing the power button for less than half a second, the device does not show any reaction, detecting a zero current. As in the previous case, it's necessary to make measurement on the motherboard, starting with the power button. In addition, a visual inspection is essential to reach an adequate diagnosis. Later in this course, we'll make some of these measurements. Observing the power button, the consumption of 66 milliamperes indicates that this step is okay. When we press the power button for more than a second, the device doesn't exceed 97 milliamperes. This means that during the boot process, the integrated circuits were not correctly activated, as the consumption should follow an ascending graph in order for the device to work properly. Therefore, it's necessary to check the problem in order to solve it, making measurements on the motherboard. In the first case, we can observe an ascending graph with many operations at the same time. The current rises quickly and then stabilizes. As it is a high-end device, the graph is very saturated and there is a large input of current.